Hello, everybody. This is the one and only Mr. LP of Enliven Global Media. We're here at Lido Pizza, and we just had a wonderful conversation of women. Why are you single, ladies? And we wonderful. Sorry, I'm tired.
That's okay.
Sorry, my ankle's killing me so much pain. Okay. Hello, everybody. This is the one and only Mr. LP of Enliven Global Media. We're here in Glen Allen, Virginia, in Lido Pizza. Thank you very much for Carlson Coleman Group LLC for supporting us. And we are here. We just had a wonderful conversation. Ladies, why are we single? And we had a wonderful, great discussion with a lot of great people. And thank you for coming out. But we had a wonderful vendor that also joined us. And I'm going to let her introduce herself.
Hello, my name is Shawmica Tompkins. I'm an independent consultant for Paparazzi Accessories.
How are you doing, young lady?
I'm wonderful. Thank you for inviting me.
Thank you. Now, question. What did you like most about the conversation that we just had?
The openness and the respect. I like the fact that everybody was able to communicate their point. People were able to have disagreements and to have them in a respectable manner. And that's what we need. We need to be able to communicate.
So I thought I wasn't doing right. Nobody pulled out any hair through glasses or nothing.
That's not what we do. We have to show people that even though we can have disagreements, we can have respectable disagreements. I can respect your opinion, your differences, and that's what makes us diverse and unique. And that's what brings flavor to the conversation.
Amen on that one. Now, you are a very, you have a business here. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yes, like I said, I'm an independent consultant for Paparazzi's Accessories, which is jewelry that sells for $5 plus tax. We also have a new collection, the Z collection, and those items sell for $25 plus tax. And so as an independent consultant, I'm able to do direct sales. I work events such as this one today. I can host parties at your home. I do Facebook Live parties and I sell my jewelry that way. And it's a way to earn additional income for myself and for my family.
Amen. Well, we've got one coming up soon, so we're going to definitely let you know about that. Now, the other question I want to ask you now as a businesswoman, well, first off, what made you decide to get involved with this versus all the different things that a woman can do?
Well, I'm going to tell you, the thing about Paparazzi that stood out, when the opportunity was shared with me, it was something different. I had a mindset of an entrepreneurship, and I was looking for something to do. And everybody was doing different things that were direct sale that are very common, such as, if I can say, Herbalife, Avon, Mary Kay, but the market was flooded with those things. I had not heard of Paparazzi. So when it was shared with me, I said, this is something different. Then I went and I saw the jewelry. And I said, wait a minute, as a consumer and as a woman, these are items that I would buy. So I felt confident in being able to sell them because I knew that the everyday woman, such as myself, wants to get a deal, wants to get a bargain, and wants to look good. And that's what this jewelry is about.
Aren't you the everyday? You just rolled up in here with a nice BMW and all this other stuff. You're not the everyday woman.
Well, I'm going to tell you, I don't drive a BMW yet. But at the same time, even a woman who drives a BMW, I don't care if you drive a BMW, if you drive a Bentley, I don't care if you drive a Hooptie. You're the everyday woman because nobody wants to be frivolous with our money. The Bible says we have to be good stewards. Amen. So if you're going to be a good steward, then you have to make sure you're using your money wisely. So that's why I think if you're going to buy a necklace set for $5 and get the earrings for free, why not do that versus going to other places and spending $20 for the same piece?
Now, as a woman of color and things, what does it mean to you to be able to own a business as representing as a woman of color?
Well, I'll tell you, a lot of our children, especially African-American children, different minorities, we don't have the mindset and we don't instill it in our children and our youth to gain that residual income. We don't put it in our youth that you can do it. You can be the achiever. You can be the one who is owning your own and thriving and striving in your business. So it's important for me as a woman of color and as a mother to show my daughter that you can be independent and you can do your own. You don't always have to work under somebody else. You can make your own way.
Now, the question I want to ask you is, you are your mother?
I am.
Okay. So we have to give a shout out to children.
My daughter is Janae Price. Hey, Janae, she's 13 years old and she is my riding banana.
Wait. At 13, you don't look at bear. You look 18, 21 yourself.
Sir, I'm 35 years
go
young.
Go ahead. So how does it feel now? Who's running? Is she 13 trying to run the show now?
She does try to run the show, and because she is 13 and she's coming into her own, some decisions she is able to make, and I think that's part of growing. I don't think that's part of her running necessarily the show or getting over. I think it's a part of growth and maturity. I have to give her some responsibility to see how she handles it in terms of making some decisions for herself, and then that way that can better prepare her for as she gets older.
Now, I set you up. That question is now that how what kind of things are you trying to show her as a businesswoman? You are you work 9 to 5, and then you are a businesswoman with this independent dealer. How does all of this, what kind of examples are you trying to hope that your daughter see in this?
What I want her to see is that she should be a go-getter and don't put all your eggs, so to speak, in one basket. Have more than one avenue or more than one revenue of income. You have to build a portfolio. It's important to have different things such as your investments like your 401k. It's important to have a primary career. It's important to also have a way that if this folds, what else can I do? What's my plan B? Have a plan B. Have a plan B and work it. Work that plan B just as hard as you work your plan A, because you never know what may happen in one avenue. Anything going in one place, okay, I'm okay. I don't have to go into panic mode because I've made provisions. And that's what I want her to know. Be prepared. Make provisions for yourself so that you don't find yourself needing a handout.
Now, where are you from, may I ask?
I'm from the city of Richmond, and I reside in Southside.
Oh, we so sorry. We're going to hold a prayer for you? No, I'm sorry.
I love Southside.
Were you born in Southside?
No, I actually came up in Northside.
Oh, so how are you going to come to Southside, Northside? You're supposed to represent, North Avenue, Chamberlain, everything. Why are you defected?
It's just that when I moved, and the home that I live in now, it was located in Southside, and I came over to Southside years ago, even before I bought my home, and I met so many nice people and good people over in Southside, and my grandparents are there. So
okay, so I won't give you the joke of it. You telling everybody in Northside that you don't like them, you don't rock with them like that no more.
Not that. It's just that my family, I had some family in Southside, which also kind of drew me and pulled me to Southside, and I met really good people, and it just became home.
Now, I ask that because we see a big growth, an explosion of a lot of women, a lot of businesses of people of color, but now especially women of color are having all these businesses out here. And it's good because I want to show that there's room for everybody no matter what you do.
Oh, yes. And the thing about it is that I support my sisters. I support any woman that's trying to do something. Sometimes I will go places as a vendor, and there are other women there, women of color, non-color, whatever the case is. I go, and if they have something on their table, I go and I try to find out what can I buy. Even if it's not something that I can utilize, can I buy something from this woman to support her in her business? Even if it's something I can buy and give away as a gift to someone, because it's all about support. It's all about connecting. It's all about passing the word, networking, that this woman is trying. So I'm not gonna knock her hustle. I'm going to help her with hers if I can.
Now, what did you learn more about yourself that you didn't realize as you started this business and that you worked to improve?
What I learned more about myself is that I'm able to be more flexible and be more able to be a little bit bolder. I'm a bold person as it is, but I don't like to ask for things. And so as a vendor, you have to ask. The same way I reached out to you and I asked you, can I come? May I come
and
to
I
your
say,
event?
Hell no.
But you have to humble yourself, and you have to say, you know what? Instead of being the one who's saying, I'm going to do this, you have to be able to humble yourself and say, I'm going to ask my brother, or I'm going to ask this person, or ask this company, can I come out? And it's hard to ask because rejection can be a little bit hurtful. And then I've also learned that more about the financial aspects of budgeting. Because in order to see your gains, you also have to see, okay, how much am I putting into my business? So I had to open a separate account, go down to the bank and do some more different things there. So it teaches you to prepare for taxes and to keep things in order. Because when it comes tax season, everything has to be in order. You don't want to mix the two with your business money and your personal money.
Amen on that. Now, did you go to college or where did you go?
I'm a registered nurse. I'm an associate's degree nurse, so yes, I did go to a career college, and I've also been to J. Sargent Reynolds. Okay. I got my LPN through there, and then I went to Bryan and Stratton, and I became a registered nurse. And prior to that, I was a certified nursing assistant.
So you just all the way going.
I mean, you got to get going, and I'm going to tell you, once you get started with anything, the best advice I can give anybody is whatever you start, finish it. Finish it through. Finish it through to your satisfaction. Don't just work something for a short period. Work it, work it, work it until you get to where you're satisfied.
And you kept going to school while you were, even after you had your child, you kept on going and going all the way through.
Absolutely. I can remember the days when I had to take my daughter with me as she was a newborn baby. I had to take her with me to class sometimes because there were tests and exams that had to be taken. And sometimes I would go take the test. She would be in her carrier, take the test. Then I may leave the class, but at the same time, you get marked down if you don't go, if you don't take it on time. So You have to be persistent. You can't let one thing come up to say, oh, well, because of this, I can't. Because of that, I can't. Because it's always going to be a something. So don't let your somethings stop you from getting to where you need to be. That's what I encourage every woman, every person.
So what is left for you going on? We're, you know, we're already in the holiday season in 2017 going on through, and we're almost a bit of October. What is the rest of this year looking like for you and also 2018?
Okay, well, as for me, with this company, Paparazzi's Accessories, we're able to rank up, so to speak, in the company, which means the more consultants that I get to join my team, I can grow in the company and build more residual income. So I have goals for Paparazzi Accessories that I want to rank up because I want to continue to grow. And that's what I mean when I say continue to work your business and work whatever plan you have. I want to work with Paparazzi until I get to a level where I'm comfortable with. Then I have a few other things that I want to do, personal goals that I don't want to share at this time. But financially, I do want to continue to work this business. This is my primary focus right now. This is like my new baby. So I'm trying to grow my baby, nurture my baby, pour into my baby, and let this business grow.
So I'll be sure, you know, this time next year, we're going to go for the next house, investing and everything else.
Well, I don't know about another house, but I think this time, this year, because my whole thing is I do believe in living comfortably, and I don't believe in living within my means. I believe in living below your means. So I'm not so excited about getting another house because there's no need. But I do want to live within my below my means and still have income that I can be comfortable with. And I think Paparazzi is going to help get me there.
Amen. I thank you so very much. How can people get in contact with you?
Okay, well, my name is Shawmica Tompkins.
First off, you got to spell all of this. Oh. Not everybody went to Sesame Street, okay? You know, Shawmica spelled a lot of different ways, exactly. So I need you to help me out.
Okay, so Shawmica Tompkins, Shawmica Tompkins, Tompkins. You can contact me via phone, 804-852-0131. And also my website, you can go online and make purchases at www.MissMica'sTreasureChest. And that's MSMICAS treasurechest.com.
Okay, we got all of that out. Woo! Okay, you know, and say spell the name one more time, a little bit slow. I'm not working on the full speed, so say okay. One more time.
Shawmica Tompkins, Shawmica Tompkins, Tompkins. I look forward to hearing from you all.
Okay, a couple of fun questions.
Yes.
Favorite color?
Purple.
Favorite movie?
Don't have one. Oh. I would say the color purple, though. I really do love the color purple.
Favorite book?
I think it's called The Reader.
If you had $5, what would you spend it on?
I'm sorry, it's called The Notebook. And if I had $5 right now, I would spend it on some Paparazzi.
Okay, well, if you have, besides Paparazzi, what would you spend the $5 on?
I really would go to the dollar store because I rack up at the dollar store. I go to the Dollar Tree and I get some good deals. So anything in the dollar store, I just take my time and comb the aisles. I would just go on a little spree at the dollar store.
Favorite meal?
Oh, give me some steak and potatoes and put some gravy on it.
Who's your favorite actor and actress?
Actress would be Angela Bassett. And actor, I don't really have a favorite actor, but I do really admire Sidney Poitier.
Good choice.
He's very classic, and he's like one of my all-time favorites because of the fact that what he was able to accomplish in a time where that was not ideal.
Favorite city you ever visited?
I did visit New York City, and I did really enjoy it there.
Favorite place you want to visit that you just have not had a chance to go to?
I would love to go to Mexico. I have not been to Mexico yet, and I would love to go.
Mexico City or somewhere in the Baja?
Mexico City. I want to go get that authentic Mexican, because I love the culture. And living in the south side of Richmond, you see, and even just in Richmond in general, you see a lot of Hispanic people. And I really welcome. I think it's a great thing that we have so much diversity in Richmond. But I really would like to go and get that authentic culture feel and be there.
If you had a superpower, what would you use it? What would that be? What would you use it on?
My superpower would be healing. I see so many sick people, and I would be willing to heal people, not just their physical body, but in the mental state, because I see so many people who are sicker than what they have to be because they have so many issues that they haven't dealt with and don't know how to deal with and don't know how to cope with. So I would be a healer.
What is one issue out there now that if you could, besides healing with that, you know, social, political, educational, what is one thing you could try to fix if I can give you a magic wand?
I would fix all the separation, segregation, and racism. I would just make it a level playing field, because my whole thing is that we are all people, whether you're black people, whether you're African-American, Caucasian, Asian, or what have you. We are all people. We are all of the same structure, the same abilities, same. So we all bleed the same red blood. And I just don't see how the love can be there, how there's a separation there. So I would do something to fix that mindset, that gap.
Final question. You said you're 35. Mm-hmm. You're 17 and a half, about to turn 18, about to get ready to graduate. What would you tell yourself now not to do that you could tell yourself? If you could talk to Shawmica, 17 and a half, almost 18, what would you tell her?
One of the panelists who was here, Cam, she made a good point. She said when she was single, she was working on her. If I could tell myself, 17 and a half, going on 18 years old, I would say, and I say this to young people that I talk to now, focus on you. Focus on you. Do what you need to do to get you ahead, and everything else will fall in place. Don't focus on what your friends are doing. Don't focus on if you have a boyfriend, if you have a girlfriend. Don't focus on being with the in crowd. Focus on you. I would tell myself to just pursue heavily and wholeheartedly my goals and my dreams, and watch everything else fall in line.
Amen. I thank you so very kindly so much.
Thank
I appreciate
you for having me. All right,
love talking
Take care.
To you. No problem.
Appreciate
Y'all have a fun day, everybody.
Take care.
When it comes to preparing for your financial future, there's no better time to start than today. In fact, it's pretty simple. I'm interested in what matters to you most and providing financial guidance, tools, and solutions to help you succeed. Planning for the future shouldn't be complicated. Let me help you make it simple.